No notes. Yes. Hello, and welcome to another episode of the No Notes Show. And today's episode is going to be a little different. Something new, as always, as we always like to bring it. We let it do what it do. So, we're going to get right into it right away. And today's topic is going to be, first, the EP is doing a little something different from Her Story. Usually we do Her Story. And we feature a particular person in Her Story, and we give some information on that particular person, and then we let you know where to go research if you want to look into it for yourself. But today we're going to do a little something different. Then after that, we're going to get right into 25 things the No Notes Show wants you to know. So without further ado, we're going to give it over to the EP for a minute, and then we'll proceed on. EP, what's up?
Top of the afternoon to you.
The infamous no notes.
Infamous. I like that. Infamous.
The infamous no notes.
The one and only.
The one and only no notes. We have documentation. Do you guys have your pens and paper?
We have our pen and paper ready.
All right. So this is just a little exercise to show that, you know, we all see the world a different way. All right?
Should we both have pen and paper, or is all right if just one of us has pen and paper?
Well, if you guys want to share, that's fine.
Oh, wait, yeah, we can share. Okay, so without further ado.
You ready?
Ready.
Okay, so I'm going to read you a short story about love and murder. All right?
Okay.
Okay, this is called Pigman.
Pigman. Okay.
Ready?
Ready.
Okay. A married couple live in a house on one side of a river. The wife has a lover who lives on the other side. The only way to get across the river is to walk across the bridge or to pay the boatman. The husband has to go on an overnight business trip to a faraway town. The wife pleads with him to take her with him. She knows that if she doesn't go with him, she would be unfaithful. The husband absolutely refuses to take her because she will only be in the way of his business. So the husband goes alone.
Okay.
That night, the wife goes over the bridge and stays with her lover. Dawn is almost up when the wife leaves because she must be back home before her husband returns. She starts walking across the bridge, but she sees an assassin waiting for her on the other side. She knows if she tries to cross, he will murder her. In terror, she runs up the side of the river and asks the boatman to take her across the river. But he wants too much money. She doesn't have enough, so he refuses to take her. Mm. The wife runs back to the lover's house and explains her predicament and asks him to pay the boatman. The lover refuses, telling her it's her own fault for getting into this situation.
Oh, wow.
As dawn comes up, the wife decides to dash across the bridge. She comes face to face with the assassin, and he kills her. Mm. Okay. Mm. So, the five characters in the story are the assassin, the boatman, the husband, the lover, and the wife. You write that down in that order?
In that order?
In that order. So assassin?
Okay, yeah. Assassin, boatman, husband,
boatman,
lover,
husband,
and wife.
Okay, lover and wife. OK. Okay, we got it.
Okay, so using the numbers 1 to 5, 1 being, you know, top, and 5 being, you know, the highest, and 5 being the least, I guess.
Right.
List who you think was most responsible using number 1, and all the way to 5, least responsible using number 5 for the wife's death.
Responsible for the wife's death.
Who was most responsible?
Who was most responsible?
Oh, in order, most to least.
Who's least responsible for the wife's death?
1 through 5.
Don't say anything. Just write what you think.
And five is the most responsible. Five is the least responsible.
Well, okay.
Sorry.
Five is the least responsible.
Right.
Right.
Okay.
Okay, done.
You both did it?
Yeah, well, this is what I
almost said. Wife is the
most responsible. You can put it on the right side, what you think.
I got the wife. Okay.
Doc is doing his picks. Okay, so we got we did our picks.
Oh, let me compare.
Okay,
just
good,
carry
good,
out.
Good.
I'm not gonna change anything.
We're just comparing
okay.
Notes.
Okay.
Okay. Okay. So now, all right. So we both did our. Huh?
So who thinks that the assassin was most responsible?
I don't.
Who thinks the boatman is most responsible?
I don't.
No, I don't either.
Who's that? Who thinks the husband is most responsible?
Nope.
Are you getting nervous, aren't you?
I want to get nervous.
The plot thickens.
Who thinks the lover is most responsible?
Nope.
Ta-da! Little drum roll.
That means you know who
we. Little drum roll.
You know who we pick.
You not befuddled, are you?
Who thinks the wife is most responsible?
Yes.
Yes, the wife is most responsible.
The wife is your number 1. Right. Okay, and why?
Because if she wasn't being deceitful and cheating in the first place, she would be still alive at home waiting for the husband to come home.
I concur.
So that means what you're saying is, you know, she went out and did something wrong, so she deserved to die.
Right. I mean, because, it was already going on.
As a close associate of ours would say, that's the consequences.
Right. Here you go. And she suffered the consequences.
So that's, boop, so that's
to her actions.
Anybody.
Anybody
that goes out and does the wrong deserves to die.
Well...
Yes, they deserve consequences.
Right, they deserve consequences.
Whatever the consequences are, that's what they deserve.
Okay, that's your number 1. Your number 1 was the wife.
Right. Yes.
My number 1 was the assassin.
Oh, well, why wasn't this answer? Why? Because
what's your rationale?
I said, I think that he's responsible for her death because he killed her.
No, but it was at it was
most responsible.
Most responsible because he took, I mean, he took the final step. But leading up to that were other factors.
Had she not been involved with him, it would never have happened.
Right.
So it has to start with her.
Right. It starts with her.
So what if she was over on the other side, you know, doing something else?
Oh, she happened to be over there by accident. That's one thing. Well, but you said they were having an affair.
Right.
So
that was my impression.
She had an affair with, you know, her lover, and she deserved to die.
Right.
Okay.
I'm not saying so much she deserved it. She's most responsible because I'm saying she's responsible because of her death
and what
because of her actions.
Whatever those consequences were. In this case, it was death.
It was death.
I mean, you know.
I'm not saying she deserved to die, but those were the consequences.
That's what,
Yeah.
All right. So.
Who's number two? What's your number two?
My number two was the husband. And
the husband.
I mean, because look, I mean, look at it. I say the husband because obviously he might have. I'm just thinking hypothetically, he might have knew about the affair. So listen, he might be like he might have hired the assassin. He might have set it up to where. Oh yeah, I'm a go on a business trip or whatever, or I'm gonna leave and I'm gonna intentionally leave her just to see what she's going to do. He might not even went anywhere. He might be in the bushes somewhere watching.
That sounds like an interesting plot.
So
that's a conspiracy.
Doc's pick was number two was the lover.
Oh, that's it.
The lover. Well, he's engaged
because
with the wife.
He's perpetrating the action. Had it not been for him enticing her to come to him, then she would never have been confronted with that situation, that scenario. So I feel though
she went to him. The story said she went to him
to try to get
him the vote. He wouldn't give it to her.
Right. Well,
no,
but that's a good point.
That's a valid point. Right. But still, that's sort of like after the initial, again, it goes back to the initial fact that they were both involved in an affair. So I'm saying that because he enticed her with the affair to come to him, I feel as though he would be second responsible for her death. All
right.
So you're saying that people who tempt other people,
they have to share any responsibility.
Like, okay, for instance, let's take it out of this one. Say, you know, a man goes to he's out at night, he walks past a strip club, and it's enticing, so he goes in. And when he comes out, he's going home to his wife, he gets killed.
Because he went to the strip club?
Because that strip club was enticing to him, and, you know, he wanted to go in. Does the wife deserve the right to sue the strip club?
Because they provide the temptation.
Right. Well, I mean, this also old school rules. I mean, it takes two to tango.
But going back to the lover, the fact of the matter is, again, had she not been involved in an affair with him, she would never have crossed the bridge.
Right.
So, well, my number two was the lover because.
Okay.
He was with her, and I guess he got what he needed and was like, all right, whatever, but I know, okay, somebody's across there waiting for you to kill you, but I'm not going to help you.
Now, that part, that was the second part I would hold her responsible for as well. That's it.
You said you and EP agree as number two.
Yeah, my one rationale of what I said, you know, he being a part of the equation, but the second is what you said. I agree with that wholeheartedly, the fact that you were the one enticing her to come over there, and yet you wouldn't, you know, come to her aid when she needed you most. So, yeah, I agree with that wholeheartedly.
So I said, just going, you know, my number three, well, I said the lover, only because I put him at number three because, you know, the woman is married. He's not. I mean, we go back to a couple episodes where we say, you know, we talked about something not like this, something similar. And said that, okay, well, you know, the third party involved is simply saying, well, you're the one that's married. I mean, you take all the risks. So, I mean, he knows the deal, but he's like, well, I mean, as you can see, he didn't give her the money. So he's like, here it is. You take all the risks. I ain't getting involved with that. I got what I needed.
I've heard that rationale from females in terms of they were talking about females dealing with athletes.
Right.
Yeah. And on TV, on a program I was watching, and they were saying, and they were talking to the females, I forgot the title they had for the women, that when the guys go on, when the athlete go on a road trip, they meet them at that city, and they set them up and everything, they have a fair. And when they were interviewing the women, they were asking more, like, why would you do that? Her response was, he's married, I'm not.
Right.
So they feel that responsibility and onus is on you to be responsible, and it's your obligation to, you know, respect your wife and all that kind of.
Who was your number three, EP?
My number three is the wife.
The wife, okay. Okay, because she's pulled into a love triangle.
She were enticed. Let me use a. Was she the victim?
She had this problem. She admitted to herself that she had this problem.
Right.
And she was trying to fix it by going with her husband.
Right.
You know, but he said nah.
Right.
So she could have stayed at home and did something else, but she decided to go across and see her lover.
Yeah, I guess that's an interesting look.
That's interesting. I mean, so you're saying
number three.
Number three for me was the lover. Number three for Doc was the boatman.
The boatman.
But so you said number three for was the wife, and okay, that act that she did take, the fact that she wanted to go on the business trip, if she didn't go, she was going to her lover, and she was trying to resist that, then yes, I could see that. If she was just doing it out of act, just making it look good, like she was, I wanted to go, but she wouldn't let me, so okay.
Yeah.
Now I'm gonna do what I have to do. Okay, yeah, I can see that rationale.
Now I picked the boatman because, I mean, the boatman could have helped her out.
He could make some kind of arrangement.
I'm thinking hypothetically again that he's just a transport. He may know what's going on, he may not. I'm leaning on the side that he may not know, but you know, he's more about the money.
And that's just going to negotiation, though.
His position is about the money. So he's trying to maximize, well, I got to go back, and then I got to come back over here and get your husband, too. So he's just flat out trying to maximize his profit.
I kind of hold him responsible for the fact that this wasn't her first trip.
No.
So he should have some idea of who she is. I would think that, you know, not...
No, she walked across the bridge. She walked across the bridge.
And
so
boated back. Okay. But that wasn't her first time across the bridge, right?
Not that day.
No. Yeah, so she normally walked over and ride back.
She's going back and forth with the affair.
Yes, so I'm saying at some point she caught the boat, but she walked each time.
Right.
Was this her first time encountering a boatman, is what I'm trying to say?
Right. That was her first time encountering a
boatman. Oh, well, so all the more reason, he's all about the money. He's all about the money.
I thought they had...
She walked back, but she saw the assassin.
Yeah.
So she went to the
boatman. So he's all about, again, going back to maximizing his bottom line. He's trying to get some money.
Yeah, he's about the business.
Yeah, he's about business. Who was your number four, EP?
My number four was the boatman.
The boatman. Okay, so and number four for Doc was the assassin. The assassin.
Oh, okay.
Yeah. So
why was that?
I had the boatman three.
Yeah.
Why was the boatman number four for Doc?
Number three.
No. Four was the assassin.
Three was the boatman for me.
Three was the boatman.
Okay. Why was the assassin your number four? Me and Kalupski agree with boatman. Why did you say that?
Because I'm going in terms of not priority, but who would be most responsible, who could have avoided the process from happening. And I had the wife, and then I had the lover,
boatman,
and then the boatman, because the boatman to me was the transport back and forth. So by him denying her, I felt like he was the next highest person responsible for her death.
Boatman.
My thing, the boatman could have very easily had negotiated something. I'm thinking in terms of that they had a history where he had, she had taken a boat at some point in time in the past, and that he should basically know her, and they should have been able to work out some kind of payment arrangement the next time you come, or some kind of arrangement should have been worked out where, okay, you don't have anything now, okay, I'll see you tomorrow, and you pay me X, some kind of business installment plan could have been worked out. So since he didn't do that, then I held him third responsible for her death.
Yeah.
Well, because he couldn't negotiate a payment.
Yeah.
That's all I'm saying. Yeah.
As far as the assassin being your number four?
Yeah.
Yeah.
And number five for me was the assassin, because he's the least he's the end result. The consequence.
Yeah, the consequence.
Of all that happened. So, you know, he's just coming in to do the dirty work. Watch. And then really, I just think my lineup, the way I have it, you know, wife guilty off the top. So it's her fault initially. So you got to face whatever's coming. So, in the end, that's what came. Mm-hmm. So he said, okay, well, you know, I got paid to do a job. I got to take you out. Boom. That's my thing. I'm just thinking hypothetically about the story. Of course, in the story, it doesn't say anything about somebody getting paid.
He's professional.
But if you read between the lines, you know, that's how it could have played out.
The more you ponder, the more you can twist it and shift the husband's priority around, because like you said about the conspiracy theory, had he had some connection with the assassin and knew the situation and scenario, that if he didn't take her on a business trip and she did go to meet her husband, that would be her consequence.
Right.
So that's interesting.
How do you know the assassin wasn't hired
by the lover?
By the lover.
Well, that's kind of weird.
He wouldn't pay for her to get across the
But that's only because his involvement is only hit and quit. He's probably not trying to put out.
That's where he drew the line for his responsibility.
Okay.
He got his payment already.
He knew he was getting it, right? Why wouldn't he pay for her to go in the boat if she told him somebody's trying to
get it? He should have.
Well, no.
He wasn't obligated to, but he should have.
Right, but maybe not. Maybe he got a line. He might have a line of honeys. So she's just a number in the mix.
With men like that, the more the merrier. Why would he?
That's just an open question.
And then sometimes too, some men, there are men that feel as though women are trying to play them, in terms of he might have been thinking, okay, you knew you was coming over here, you should have brought the fee to get back.
Well, yeah.
So some men feel like women have a tendency to feel like I'll rub a man's head and he'll give me anything I want. Yeah. And see, some men are very harsh and very cold towards that. So when she came back and said, oh, I need money for the boat, his thinking might have been, well, she should have brought money. I'm not giving her anything. Some guys are like that but check this out. Somebody could have burnt him in the past. Another woman could have hustled him for some money for whatever the reason was. And he made a vow that he would never do that again. Women back in the day, women used to claim they were pregnant and then want the man to give them money for an abortion, and come to find out they weren't pregnant at all. I knew a woman personally
to get on a boat and cross a river.
But I'm saying the scenarios and conspiracies that women do to get money from men, he could have been burnt in another scenario, right, and felt like, you know what, I'm not giving her any money,
right,
for whatever reason.
But this right here was,
somebody trying to kill her. So she goes,
but he doesn't know that.
Somebody's trying to kill me. Please help me. He said, oh, God, that's on you.
Hey, well, it is what it is. You knew coming in with it.
But check this out. Check this out.
The lover could have hired the assassin. He could have. That's just another possibility.
But going back to the cliche they have that about when a boy cried wolf too many times, people don't take it serious. So if say for instance you come to Steve and say, hey, I'm pregnant, I want to get an abortion, you know, give me money. He finds out that you're not pregnant, and that was just a way of you getting money from him. Let's say the two of you break up, he meets another woman, she comes and says, Steven, I'm pregnant, I need money to get an abortion. She truly is pregnant. But from your experience, he'll say, you know what? You find a way to pay for the abortion. Is he wrong? You see, when you cry wolf too much, you kind of mess up for the next person who's a genuine.
Yeah. So this is,
you understand what I'm saying? When one person does something and is fake, and then another person comes along and they're genuine, how are you supposed to distinguish? You've been burnt once.
So that's, okay.
This is good. This is good. EP, you should come up with
that's
more.
That's why I use the EP.
This is good.
You never cease to amaze me.
So this little exercise was very interesting. We hope that everybody will enjoy this.
Just when I thought I seen it off.
We need to get into our 25 things. What's up?
Is this the punchline?
Okay, I'm done. Okay, so basically, what do you have for number one? Because it says your list reveals the order in which these five qualities interest you and how important they are in your life. If you thought that the wife was most responsible, then fun is the most important thing in your life. Since you are assigning responsibility, you are essentially abandoning the quality associated with each character. Therefore, if you assign the wife as number one spot, you have betrayed fun more than any other qualities.
All right. Well, one is what we both picked.
So. You're betraying fun.
Wife is number one for both of us.
You say you're betraying fun.
Yeah, more than any other of the qualities. So number one, so if you did the wife, that's fun. Okay. Who's your number two?
Number two is the husband for me. Number two was the lover.
Okay, number two, the husband is love.
Is love.
Okay.
Yeah.
Okay.
What's
your number three?
Number three was the lover for me and the boatman for Doc.
The lover is sex. The boatman is magic.
Okay.
And the assassin equals money.
Okay, number four. So I had number four for the boatman. Number four, the assassin. So what's number four say?
Assassin?
I had boatman for number four.
One is the wife is fun. Can you write that down? Like the key.
The wife is fun.
The key somewhere on the bottom, like, you know, key wife equals fun.
I'm just put one fun. What was two again?
No, what do you have for number two? Like, do you have
number?
Yeah,
see, it's based on what you pick.
But the wife and the husband and the lover, they all represent fun, love, and
two was for Doc was lover.
Lover is sex.
Wife is fun. You know what I mean?
The number. Boatman is magic.
Boatman is magic.
Yes. And the assassin is money. And guess which one I had number one?
Assassin is.
Monk with assassin?
The assassin.
Oh, that's good. And what's number. So, wife, boatman, lover. So what was husband? He's the last one.
Husband is love.
Okay, good.
Interesting. Just to keep, okay.
Very interesting activity.
Little food.
Brought to you by the No Note Show, by the EP. all right.
The EP.
That was fun. So, of course, if you wanted to learn more about that little activity, you can email us, and we'll give you the email address as always before the end of the show. And we can give you details on how to do that activity with your friends and family. So, 25 things. So, let's jump right into it. Number one, first and foremost, number one, we absolutely, without a doubt, thank all our fans for all the support that they give us on the regular basis. We appreciate it. We love it. We hope it continues. We hope that you as fans already, will bring in more fans for us and as we continue to grow. So that's the number one thing. Number one at the top of the list that we wanted you to know. I'm going to do number two, and then I'm passing it off to Doc. Number two, this is more for the men, more for the men. PSA testing for prostate cancer. A lot of controversy going on. For those that may not know, this is why we want you to know. As of May 21st, it has been put out that the PSA test itself can be more harmful to men than good, because I guess based on the results of the PSA, it can lead to unnecessary treatments that can cause other problems. For example, blood clots, impotent. If you like say if you're, for example, a fairly young guy, and you know maybe a result comes out and maybe it could be questionable, and you take on extensive treatment, it could cause other problems in the body. So I guess the argument is, for years now, the PSA has helped with finding evidence or being conclusive in terms of if you need a treatment or what type of treatment you need, or if you need surgery to remove the prostate, or however it goes. But now it seems like it's more harm being done than good. So our advice is, of course, you know, and we talked about this on Men's Health. We did an episode. You know, consult with your doctor, discuss it, you know, and determine the plan, or determine what's best for you, and then you can make your own conclusion as to what steps you want to take pertaining to your health. But very important, PSA is an important test. Whether it's more harm than good, I mean, there's so many things that are harm that can be more harmful than good for you out here today. I mean, all the way down to the food that we eat. So, I mean, it's just, you know, it's just something else to put in your mind and or put on your list of all the other harmful things that can be bad for you, mm-hmm. to your body. But for the men, you know, we recommend that you should, you know, conduct screening. I mean, better safe than sorry. It's your health. And then, of course, you make the best decisions for your health. So that's number two. Number three?
Number three is, again, before any treatment, you should have an in-depth discussion with your doctor in terms of your options, in terms of the effectiveness of the test, because they also claim that in your PSA test, where you might have a high elevation or a high number, anything over four is sort of alarming. And that's with most doctors, then they want to start prescribing treatment. It's been shown that you can have a high number and not necessarily have prostate cancer. Some doctors tend to overreact. And then the other case could be that you can take on a certain treatment or whatever, and your numbers may go down. And that doesn't necessarily represent the fact that you don't have cancer. So basically, the test is inconclusive.
Which is,
you still should be under some sort of medical supervision.
Right.
And again, I guess the more information you get, then like anything, you can make a more informed decision.
Sure.
So we're not advocating to ignore your doctors or avoid your doctors. We're still encouraging to take the PSA test. Well, consult with your doctor. And again, it has to be a relationship, again, where you have a certain, for lack of a better word, a certain trust with your doctor. But some doctors, it's all about the chicks and almighty dollar. You know, they're pushing pills or pushing a certain treatment, whatever the case may be. That you'll never know. But hopefully you'll have a tight relationship with your doctor that, you know, he could rise above the money part of it.
Right.
But right now it's sort of up in the air. Like Stephen was saying also, the diet is also very important as well. Mm-hmm. Because as men grow older, your prostate does automatically enlarges, which create multiple trips to the bathroom, especially at night. But if it's just a question of, I think they call it, I think it's BNHR, I think the letters. But whatever it is, it could be enlarged prostate could be treated by medication that will bring it back to a normal size, and you'll be okay, and the urination will sort of go away at night and all that good stuff. But you first have to identify if it's prostate cancer or if it's just a, I can't think of
it. It is a medical term.
Yeah. But the medical term means you just have an enlarged prostate, which each minute over 40 or 30, your prostate automatically starts to grow. But there is medication for that. If that's the problem, you can get medication to bring that back to normal.
You got number five, or should we go to the EP?
Oh, number five?
You got number five?
In terms of, we're doing
25.
Yeah, I got a five. Okay. For the men out there, there's a website, allprodads.com. Go on there. Tony Dungy's at it again.
Oh, man.
It's family innovative, and it's where men are taught to be better fathers, and it's also supposed to be a one-stop resource for ideas for men and innovations for men about being better fathers.
Mm, yeah, good. That's
so
great.
That's all pro. That's allprodads.com.
Allprodads.com. Check it out. Yeah. EP, what you got? Number six.
Boobies, don't be afraid to touch yourself.
Whoa. Whoa. I thought you said boob. Okay. I thought you said booty. Okay, go ahead. I mean, there's a lot of emphasis on that these days with women. But go ahead, I'm sorry.
Go ahead.
I'm sorry for the interruption.
Sorry for the interruption. Number six.
Fill your boobies, don't be afraid to touch yourself. There's a way of catching breast cancer, filled with lumps, get your husband, your man, get your doctor to show them how to fill
for
lumps so we can prevent breast cancer.
Well, you're not using that as a seduction thing, are you?
No, not at all. This is health conscientious.
That's right. Some woman might try to seduce somebody and say, can you fill my breast? I think I got a lump. And trying to seduce somebody.
You going with number seven or are you passing it off?
I'll pass it off.
All right, number seven. This goes back to one of our previous shows, and I had to put this in 25 because this is just irritating to me. This is going back to the men. Please, when you put your pants on, put them on your waist. I mean, come on, man. I mean, we don't want to see. I don't want to see it. I mean, I don't know who does want to see it because I'm not. You know, I'm just cut it off at that. I'm not going to take it any further. I don't want to see it. I'm sure there's plenty of others out there in society that don't want to see it. It's too.
Did you mention the other day that somebody was walking with their pants hanging down? They had like one of a Speedo or something? Did you?
Oh, I would have never seen that. I never want to see that.
Was it that gross?
Yeah, man. Oh, geez. You know,
so nauseous?
And it's probably been done. It's probably been
done. Oh, no doubt.
I mean, that's their design to come up to your waist, and that's why you have a belt. That's why the belt was designed, because you know the pants by themselves, no, they cannot hold themselves up. That's what you have a belt for. Listen, pull the pants up, put a belt on, and walk the proper way. I mean, it's got to be too much work. It's got to be. I don't care if it's a style you think is cool, or I'm bad, I'm a bad guy, whatever, you know, don't mess with me, or whatever. Listen, however it looks, however you put it, whatever the message is, we already said it gives the wrong message. You're putting it out there, and then it just looks horrible. Especially if you somebody big. Come on, I mean, you know, you clocking 270, 300. There's no way you should be trying to drop some pants walking down the street.
With a Speedo.
And all that blubber, all that cellulite hanging. I mean, come on, man. Hey, I mean, you know. Number eight. This is going into technology. See, we're just bouncing all over with this thing. The Galaxy S3 is out. Galaxy S3, the phone. I'm talking phones right now. We want you to know about the Galaxy S3. Now, it was just announced, actually most recently, just announced yesterday that all the big carriers will be bringing out, putting on sale the Galaxy S3. And for $200 with a 2-year contract, I don't know if this is going to be across the board with every carrier, AT&T, T-Mobile, Verizon. You can get it for that price. Now, right now, retails for about $800 flat out. But it's a nice phone. It's a nice phone. I mean, I can't do $800. That's too steep for me. I mean, I would love to get it, but you know, I'm not doing $800. But anyway, this is in full competition to Apple's iPhone. And coming, in my opinion, pretty stiff competition. I mean, this phone is all that. The features, the way it works. Apple, my thing is Apple. I love Apple. But Apple got, they got some competition to work with now. I mean, this phone is off the hook. The Galaxy S3. So check it out. I mean, for those of y'all that can afford it, or maybe contract time is coming up, you want to enter into a new contract, there you go. If you can buy it flat out, I mean, if you can afford it, I say get it. I mean, it's definitely recommended. I mean, it's a nice phone. It's a nice phone. Check it out on YouTube. YouTube gives you a full video of its features, how it works. Nice phone. Nice phone. I'm going to pass off number 9 to Doc. What you got for number 9?
I'd like to revisit the fashion world. I was online the other day. I got caught up in a link with Shaquille O'Neal and his new beau, Boo. And one click led to another. Mm-hmm. And I ran across a scene where women, not to be outdone, this female had on a pair of pants with a crotch cut out.
Oh.
Yeah, crotch was cut out like from the, well, she had a waist portion, but from the waist down, all the crotch was out. And she had a little, for lack of a better word, like a patch just covering her vagina. And that was a fact. She was walking out in public like that.
And nothing else?
It was like from here.
And
all the crotch was cut out up to above the vagina and back down this area. And then all pants, and the rest was pants. The crotch.
Oh, but you,
so
but
when
now
you saw her, you saw her, you saw this was all out.
This like, was, like bear?
This was out.
Like bear?
Yeah. And then she had some sort of a garment or a patch that just covered the vagina. You can kind of just see the contour. Just covered the vagina. Huh? And she had everything else she had on the top, and you know, it was pants, but the crotch was cut out. I thought that was.
So watch your fashion.
Not to be outdone. like they say in poker, I see you and I raise you one. You haven't seen that style yet. It has something to do with hot. I was, like I said, I was clicking. I was trying to find out more about this Shaq's new lady. Her name is somebody Alexander. Mm-hmm. She was on a Flavor of Love show, and she won the contest of winning Flavor's Love, and he's dating her now. And like I said, you know, one click led to another. I'm trying to see pictures of her. And I ran across hot women or whatever, boom, boom. And next thing I know, this is what I saw. She's walking down the street, and that was the outfit that she had on. She had a normal, nice top on, everything nice. It was black pants, but just the whole crotch was cut out.
Wow.
And she had that one underneath. I guess she had some kind of little, I call it a patch, but it was like a garment. It was like a, I guess you might call it a what do you call the garments that women wear?
Thong.
I guess it was like a thong, a little thong. I call it a patch, but thong is covered. And you actually, she's walking down the street in public. This is normal.
Well, the fashion go-getters, there you go. You got number 10 or pass it to
the EP? Number 10.
Number 10, what you got?
Number 10. For the sports enthusiasts, lighten up a little bit in terms of, I mean, there are people out there that actually choose their friends and cause enemies based on teams, their favorite team, or if you're not a fan of my team, or you don't like, or you say something bad about my team, you actually fall out of Flavor with different people. I mean, I think you get, and if their team lose, I mean, their disposition changed. They, you can't live with them. You can't. So I think the sports enthusiasts should kind of lighten up a little bit. You know, sports is sports. Put things in its perspective. You know, don't choose your friends or create enemies based on sport teams. It's not worth it.
Number 11, EP.
Number 11, ladies.
Fashion.
Your man may have a vasectomy behind your back.
Oh. Cut the cord.
He's making you pop out all these kids.
What? Cut the cord.
So, if you're one of those girls that, you know, you're on a date or you, what's the matter, you're just so enthused about having kids on the first date, he might, you know, he might like you and all, but he might not want any children. Go ahead and have a vasectomy behind your back.
Oh, man.
So, yeah, I guess they should do their homework, because if she come up and says she's pregnant, yeah, okay.
Yeah.
Yeah, we'll kind of expose somebody.
You got number 12?
Cricket to sell iPhones.
Number 12, back to technology. Did it.
To sell iPhones. June 22nd, around that time, $55 a month, unlimited talk, text, and web.
That's it, Cricket. Going to the Cricket. iPhone.
iPhone 4, get yours.
iPhone 4, $55 a month, unlimited talks, tech, and web. So, and so they'll be selling the phone for, I think, $299 and $399, or is it $399 and $499?
I'm not sure.
Yeah, I think it's either $299, $399.
It's going to be around, you know, $500 for the 16 gig.
$500 for the 16 gig.
For the 8 gig. iPhone 4.
Right. Okay. All right. All right. So you got another 13, or is it on me?
You can go ahead.
Thirteen. Going back to a little bit about what we talked about recently, driving text. Seeing it a lot. Don't do it. Legislation is being worked on by President Obama for it to be passed to be outlawed in every state. It's not safe. It's almost as if you're driving under the influence of alcohol. It really just take your attention away from driving. If it's a must, I mean, there are plenty of places where you can pull over, maybe even just park and do what you had to do, and you know, then you get back on the road. But I mean, for you to get yourself in a situation where you're gonna injure yourself or injure somebody else, or maybe even it being fatal, which would be the ultimate horrific situation, just don't do it. That'd be number 13. Number 14, I gotta go into, just rewind it a little bit. Number 14, relationships. Of course, you know, No No Show is. I think we're pretty known for our relationship series. But bottom line, in a nutshell, no matter who you with, we want you to know that you should respect your partner, love your partner unconditionally, and be good to your partner always. We talked about that. Should in any relationship, it should be God first, and then you as an individual and your party as an individual. That's it. The three members of the relationship, and that's it. There should not be your girlfriends on the side, or your guy crew on the other side, or you know, whoever you outside influences should not be involved at all, because once you allow that to happen, you could just count on turmoil in your relationship. It's not going to work. And then the end result, two people that once were in love won't be anymore. So that's what we want you to know for 14. 15. Ha ha.
I guess we should brace ourselves.
15 is a big one. Education. We stress education here at the No No Show. We want you to know that education is very important for whatever level of education you're in, whether it's junior high school, your college. It gets tougher as time passes on. Each year that you excel to the next level, to the next grade, it is challenging. A lot of peer influence out there. Don't fall into the wrong influence. One way to do that is connect with people that are positive, that are about the things that you're about, which in most cases it is a positive, in the positive mode, and that will help you build your foundation, especially in cases not everybody has support at home. For those that do have support at home, you're blessed, you're fortunate to have that, but not everybody has that type of structure. So it's important to get connected with the right people. As it gets tougher, seek help. You know, whatever that is, whoever you can go to. So you can get that added support, but you cannot do anything without a proper education. High school just doesn't do it anymore. College doesn't do it anymore. You gotta excel even further. So, I mean, it doesn't have to necessarily be college either. It could be a technical school, it could be a trade. I mean, something, but don't sell yourself short. Education is very important. If you want to do anything in this life, accomplish and succeed, and be able to acquire things and be able to do things that you want to do, you gotta have a foundation, and that's education. Bottom line. That's 15. Number 16, Doc.
Number 16, I'm going to piggyback on structure. Structure for your kids. I think we should always try to teach our kids structure in terms of schedules, have them to understand what it is to be on some type of a schedule, and also chores. Teach kids, have them involved, give them some sort of chores in life. The other area I would say recreation.
18, recreation.
And recreation, and I think one of the most important things also...
I'm sorry, 17. I'm jumping the gun, 17, recreation.
The other thing I think in that structure process would be, I think for kids is also very important, is character. You know, and character is teaching your kid responsibility and teaching them to have respect for other people and other people's property. Character is responsibility, trustworthiness, and dependability. So I think that's key.
Yeah. What you got for 18, EP? 18.
Number 18, don't co-sign for anyone's car.
Ha ha! Good advice.
Very good point.
If you co-sign for someone's car and they get tickets, you get a boot.
I want to expound on that a little bit too when you finish.
Yeah.
You co-sign somebody's car, that person gets tickets. The PPA or whoever does your parking authority in your city rides by and they tag your license with your name on it. If your name is associated with a car that has a lot of tickets, you're getting the boot. So don't co-sign.
We'll bounce back to Doc for 19. What you
have? I want to piggyback on that co-signing for other people. Not only do you take your liability as far as traffic tickets and whatever, or the boot, it's also a financial responsibility. If you co-sign for someone to purchase a car and they stop making those payments, you're responsible for those payments. And if you refuse, they can come and take your house if you have a mortgage or whatever. So if that person suddenly, for whatever reason, stop making their car payments, the co-signer is the next responsible person. They're coming after you and your assets. So think very hard and long. So, I mean, it's not that it's personal, but you have to really know this individual is responsible. And even if they're responsible, nobody can predict the future. They might lose their job a month later.
Yeah.
You know, so, I mean, just be very careful about it. I mean, think real hard and long about that one. You know.
Yeah.
EP, you got 20, or is it on me?
I got bath salts or
bath salts, excellent.
Increasing across the U.S. So, you know, children are coming up, teenagers, whoever, are coming up with different ways on how to get high, you know, without actually going out there buying drugs.
Oh my
god. So now they're using bath salts. I can't imagine how. It sounds pretty painful to me, but you know, they're finding different ways, and now it's bath salts, and it's becoming, you know, it's increasing across the U.S. So keep an eye on your tweens and teens.
Oh man, that's horrible. That's
I know. I knew a personal situation where a kid got caught up in being creative in the high that he was getting, and again going to a particular school, he picked the process up, and it was household cleaning products.
Oh, yeah.
And
aerosols. Yeah,
aerosols. Yeah. A lot of household products that kids can get high on by sniffing and snorting.
So. Glue, Elmer's glue was one. I mean, it's horrible. So watch your children. Watch your children, definitely. You got a 21, or you want me to take it?
You can take 21. Just come
21.
Back.
21. Violence. It's horrible. I mean, particularly in Philadelphia. It seems like now somebody's getting shot. At least one person is getting shot, up into fatally being shot each day of the week. One to two to three people. I mean, this is crazy. It's not even summertime yet. It's ridiculous. It's hot. It shouldn't. I mean, you know, it seems like when the heat is like the crime increases, like roaches. It's like they all congregate together or something. I mean, it's crazy, but. I mean, violence anywhere is senseless. I mean, since people are dying for the most idiotic things, and who, again, I think we touched base on this a while back before too. Nobody has the right to take a life here.
No.
We're all equal. We're blessed to be here. We've been given life. Let people live their life. I mean, it's horrible. It's horrible what's going on. I mean, and I'm just speaking about one city. I mean, you know, across the board, across the country. I mean, across the world. It's just crazy. It's senseless. I mean, you know, people getting shot every day. I mean, it's horrible. And then not even just getting shot. Not just that type of crime. But other crime, for example, real quick. Just this morning, they were talking about an accident that happened in Camden, a hit and run. Young lady's dead now. The guy kept going. I mean, how do you do that? How do you do that and then go home and then get in your bed and you can sleep that off? I mean, you ran over somebody and now they're dead, and that's acceptable. I mean, or you feel justified, or for whatever reason, you feel like it's okay. Oh, I did it. All right, whatever. I mean, you have taken the life. I mean, it's just crazy. And then the other ones, people just going around shooting people like it's nothing. I mean, their parents poisoning their babies and killing them. That woman that just did that. I mean, it's sickening. Can we just stop? That's 20. You know, 21. Zimmerman. Going back to Trayvon Martin. Just so you know, just as an update on this case. Turns out Zimmerman lied about his finances in order to get out of jail, him and the wife. I think they should put the wife in jail too for lying. Yeah, conspiracy. Yeah. You know, I mean, what's up? I mean, you claim you such so innocent. What you got to lie about, bro? I mean, come on. I mean, now you back in jail, which is good. And the judge was right on it. Do his ass right back in jail.
Right. Exactly.
Because now, I mean, but then. We knew you were getting money because you had that thing.
You had the website.
That website. And then on Facebook, had that page on Facebook getting support and everything. I don't know if it still exists there, or I choose not to even type in his name to click anything that he's associated with. But, I mean, you so quote-unquote innocent, you should have nothing to hide. But good, you're back in jail. Hopefully you stay there. Where you belong until this trial gets underway, and then you'll have your day in court. So just so you know, just an update on that, he is back in jail. He was out, he lied.
He misrepresented himself,
him and his wife. And again, we feel that she should be in trouble too, but I guess that's to be determined. But we'll keep you updated on that.
And he also withheld the fact that he had a second passport.
Yeah, that too. I mean, what would you don't need to go anywhere. You should be preparing for a trial. You know.
Not seeing the world. You know.
22. What we got for 22, Doc?
22. I'm gonna stay with the kids. I'm gonna say we should. Our primary responsibility to the kids as parents should be to prepare them for the real world. And in the real world, there's gonna be hardships. There's gonna be bad times and good times. And teach them how to. Sometimes they have to work and plan and be patient for things they really want in life. It doesn't come right away. Mm-hmm. It doesn't come instantly. Teach them how to plan, how to work towards a particular goal or item that they're saving for or working towards. Be patient, you know, all things in time. Mm-hmm. And I think that's why it's so important that it's detrimental when we try to give our kids everything that we think they want. I know we say, well, we're trying to give them more than what we have, but it could be detrimental. It can be a reverse reaction to that, because then in life, when you go out in the real world, they're going to hear no, they're going to hear rejection, they're going to hear you can't have that, you can't do this, you got to be here at a certain time, you can't leave. So if you prepare them for that in their childhood, when they go out in the real world, they can adjust and adapt to these type of structures. Mm-hmm. And don't think that it's personal. People, you know, don't like them or hate them or they want to commit suicide. So
right.
You have a responsibility to prepare your child for the real world.
23 EP.
23. Only you can prevent forest fires.
Oh, I like that.
As Smokey the Bear says. Make sure your forest fires are out. Your little campfires are out before you leave the forest. That happens around, you know, summertime and around September, fall season, like people go camping and they don't put their fires out, and as a result, we have these big fires,
especially in California. Very good.
And people have to evacuate from their houses and everything. So, again, as Smokey Bear said, only you can prevent forest fires.
I like that one.
And I have another one.
24. We're almost there. Uh-oh. the gamers. Resident Evil 6. What we got?
PlayStation 3, Xbox 360, October 2nd, 2012. Be there.
It comes out October 22nd.
October 2nd.
October 2nd, 2012.
Yes.
Get it.
Yes. Are you ready?
Are you ready?
And our
number 25. Our number 25 is simply, I don't know how simple I could put it. Live, love, be good to one another. I mean, life is a treasure. I mean, to be able to wake up each morning and enjoy a day, to see another day, to enjoy another day, to embrace another day. Anything that you face, adversity that may come your way, that's all relative. That just falls into place. Count your blessings. Keep your faith, whatever that may be. We don't criticize or condemn anybody for what they believe in, but one thing we can all agree on is life is precious. Embrace every moment. Enjoy it. Appreciate it. I mean, because, you know, you never know when your day is coming. So live, love, respect, embrace, be good to one another always. And as always, before we go, you know how it is. You know how we do it. You can contact us. Do www.thenonoshow@aol.com. Please send us your thoughts, your suggestions, your comments. Again, if you want information on the activity that we did at the beginning of the show, you can do that. We'll send it to you, give you the information. You can try it out with your friends, with your family. Check us out on the venues that we use. Facebook, just go in, type in the No Notes. Brings you to our page. You can see all our shows that we're currently running. You can also leave feedback, comments, and suggestions there. Same thing with YouTube. Mm-hmm. Same thing, same deal. It's easy. It's simple. Type in No Notes on YouTube. Takes you right to our channel. All our videos, everything there. You can make comments there, suggestions, share your feedback, give us ideas, anything you want to do. We're there, you know, also through search engines. We're all over the place. Please check us out. Please support us. Please spread the word as always. And that'll do it for this episode. Until next time, Missing the No Note Show is Until then, peace.